You have been here a few days now.
Since Saturday.
Since Saturday. And why did you come in here?
Because I attempted suicide.
You attempted suicide?
Yes.
When did you do that?
Wednesday.
Could you tell us why? Or what made you feel the way you did?
Well, I didn't have any worries, but...
Interested you? Has it been that way all along, or was there a time when you were interested in things?
Oh yeah, I was interested a few years ago.
In the last few years you have lost interest. So what would you do? Just sit at home?
That's all. I was in the house for 3 weeks. I didn't go out no place.
You didn't go out at all? About your sleep? You can't sleep well. And your appetite?
Oh, I got a good appetite.
Often. What would you be doing at home? Would you do some housework?
No, we live with my brother-in-law and he has servants, so there's nothing to do.
You'd just be sitting?
Thank you. Well, at first I was playing, I actually started playing guitar. So I only started playing drums when we realized the drummer of the band that I was in was kind of bad. But it was just for fun. I mean, it was always just friends playing in the garage and playing parties and stuff. I wasn't ever really like a serious careerist kind of thing, just kind of playing for fun.
Did you ever think about what you'd do for a living? Although, while you're having fun,
just smoking pot, playing music, that's about it.
Can you talk about some of the other bands you were in?
I was in a band called Freak Baby, and I was 13 or 14. We were just kind of like really awful punk rock. And then I was in a band called Mission Impossible. We were kind of better punk rock. Then I was in a band called Scream. No, then I was in a band called Dane Bramage, and we were like a weird Mission Burma drug thing. And then I was in a band called Scream, and that's where I started touring around. So from the time I was about 17 to the time I joined Nirvana, I was touring about 8 months out of the year, just slumming around, going to Europe and playing squats, and there for a couple months and stay in Amsterdam as long as we could, and then come back to America and we just didn't want to have, we'd live fine, we'd do okay on the road, get $7 a day, be able to eat and stuff, and come home, we wouldn't really have any money, so
there were some rough times after Nevermind and Media, and you guys became these stars and everything. You seem to handle it pretty well, though.
I mean, you gotta figure that it's like, if you really deep down never expected any of this to happen, then when it actually happens, you just kind of look at it as a joke, kind of. Like, it's pretty funny when you think about it, you know, like, why should I?
Little baby, can you stitch my broken heart? machine gun started rattling off, and it got closer and closer, and this bullet just flew right over our heads, and we were terrorized. I mean, I'm getting goosebumps right now thinking about it. It's really scary, and I don't know how anybody can go through that on a daily basis. There's only two things left what's going to happen. It's either annihilation, there's not going to be a Bosnia-Herzegovina, everybody there's going to be dead. And it's getting really close to that. Things are dragging on. I mean, last count, at least 35,000 dead. I mean, that's a lot of people since, in a couple months to die. And, or there can be some kind of mediated, or something has to be done. You gotta go in there with some force. And I'm not saying to commit a bunch of ground troops, but there's a formidable air superiority the West has that can really make a difference. Just give them like a rap upside the head. Like, listen, doesn't mean you have to pulverize or annihilate them. It's just make a statement. Well, that's all.
Now you said no. In Bloom, the In Bloom video is like a beginning of an answer to all that, even to MTV or to the whole video universe.
I'm not really sure because
I'm not really opposed to videos. I don't hate them. Sometimes they're fun to do. Especially that video was fun to do because it only took us 6 hours. Normally a video will take a whole day, just like really? Over and over and over. We only had to listen to the song like 4 times. And it was great. It was really great to be able to do that. And it was totally spontaneous. Courtney had brought some dresses with her. She was taking them to a friend's house. She had borrowed some dresses from a friend of hers. And so I thought, hey, let's put some dresses on and, you know, dance around in those. And that was just, you know, everything was just pretty much spontaneous. The basic idea was just to, you know, do a video that looked like it came from the early 60s or the late 50s.
Well, what about the other version that you were marked with suits and all like that? It was done in the same day?
Yeah.
Just change your clothing?
Yeah, just change your clothing.
Okay. Well, and you mentioned that Courtney came with that those dresses, and she's recording right here. I mean, do you by any chance interfere with what she's doing in her work, or how much does one interferes with how that works?
Yeah, we get in each other's way every once in a while.
Well, yeah, but I mean, more intentionally.
We just like to be together all the time. You know, we're best friends. She's my best friend, and so when she's playing music, I like to listen to it and maybe suggest some things, and she does the same thing with me too. And this was just an opportunity for her to. She came with us, and Patty, her drummer, came too. It's just a vacation, and so this is just a spontaneous thing for them to just make a few demos and see what they're gonna do with it.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay, so
Arnaldo Baptista, is that how you pronounce his name?
That's it. Where did you hear from that? Who told you to try to listen to this band?
My friend Bill Bartel, who is he has a record label called Gasatanka Records, and he was in White Flag, and he's friends with Red Cross. He's a very nice guy. He has a mustache, and he's a really nice guy. And he sent me a tape of the first two records a few weeks ago, about a month ago, and I really liked it. And he said, if you go to Brazil, you have to say to everybody that this is a great band, and I agree with him. I think this is a very influential and cool band for the time.
How did this sound to you? Does it have a Brazilian kind of sound in the background?
Yeah, there's a lot of Latin rhythms in there in some of this music, yeah.
Because they came with this idea that let's mix Brazilian rhythm and rock, and this was in the late 60s.
Right.
Can you say something like typical from Brazil there?
Yeah, oh definitely. There's some, I can hear the rhythm and the influence in the music a lot. I respect them so much.
Gary Falwell.
Help the girl, baby.
He's got freckles.
A blood in my hair!
Buck.
I had taken from.
Think about
it. There's that neat
train. That's
for the
kids.
That
nation.
Sword of magnificence.
Made it. Good Lord, bless and keep you. Bye now.
Get ready to do a twist, a surf, a wild watusi, a frug, or a swinging holly golly.
Well,
yes, my old friend.
They're on a bummer or a trip.
This is George. He lived with his friend, the man with the yellow hat. He was a good little monkey. Good little monkey was always curious. Was always curious.
Happy birthday!
Disco. It's disco.
Mr. Pig and Sonny Too.
Boy, Sonny! Boy, Sonny!
Footage of golfing and fishing on television.
Jesus. All of your dress.
It's smelly.
Like everything tastes like chicken.
I must say.
Wow!
Now, come on.
Make that wish. Now's the time to make your wish before the other stars come out.
All righty, son.
I'll try this one more time.
Star.
But he's seen it rain.
Noise here to wake up a parking meter.
Everybody loves somebody sometimes.
Must be going now.
I know, yeah, yeah.
understand you're not from a large city area. Are you from a farm or a small town?
Small town.
What part of a small town? The so-called good side of the tracks or the other side?
The other side.
When you say the other side, exactly what do you mean? What was wrong over there?
Well, where all the guys get in trouble.
You mean the police were down there all the time?
That's right.
And you were raised in that particular area, is that right?
That's right.
How old were you when you got into what I might ask to be your first major difficulty with the law?
Well, I was 17. I stole a car.
Why a car? And why then?
Well, I got in a family argument one night, and I just didn't want to get out of town. I was mad at everybody. So I went uptown, and I stole a car, and started to leave.
What was wrong at home?
Well, that's none of your business.
You stole a car, you went uptown. How long before you were caught?
The same night.
By the county police or state police?
State police.
What happened to you then? They put you in jail?
Right.
What next?
Well, I went to court. The judge gave me probation. Beat the rap.
When you say you beat the rap, what do you mean? You didn't consider probation too heavy?
No. I thought I got pretty light on the ice.
Did you make probation all right, or did you get into more difficulty?
No, I got trouble.
What sort of trouble?
Well, I burglarized a place, got sent away before one.
For how long?
For 1 to 3 years.
So you violated your probation. Well, what did it mean to you to violate your probation? It'd be pretty rough on the average person.
It didn't bother me.
First time, the family law, so Mm-hmm.